Hello, my name is Preston Trader. I'm an insect management TDR with Monsanto. My territory covers the entire state of Illinois. We're here in central Illinois today on May 15th to talk a little bit about black cutworm. So moths overwinter in coastal regions such as Texas and Mexico, and they eventually make their way up to Illinois sometime in March through early June. They seek out kind of the vegetative areas, such as fields that are covered with winter annual weed species. They can also seek out fields that have a lot of soybean residue, some of those finer residues. They seek out these areas where they mate, and then they lay their eggs in these fields with a lot of ground cover. So black cutworm larvae have seven instars, but it's the fourth instar that we're most concerned about. We're most concerned about the fourth instar because this is when the larvae get big enough to actually cause cutting of the plants. This cutting of the plants leads to economic damage and economic loss due to stand reduction. This stand reduction, in turn, equates to yield loss. So now I'm going to talk a little bit about threshold levels. So when determining if you need a rescue treatment and you have found that you have a black cutworm problem, the thing to do is to go out into your cornfield and find five different locations within your field. You collect 20 plants from each of these five locations, and you seek out damage caused by black cutworm larvae. So the first thing to look for is kind of the pinhole feeding that occurs on the corn leaves. But more importantly to the threshold is the amount of cut plants. So seeking out 100 plants total, so 20 plants from five different locations within the field, you calculate the number of plants that you find that are cut by black cutworm larvae. If the percentage of cut plants is greater than 3 to 5%, then a rescue treatment may be warranted. So we're here today in a field where we have observed some black cutworm larval feeding. First laying eyes on the field, I notice a lot of leaves that have what looks like pinhole feeding. This generally occurs as a result of early instar feeding, and they appear like little shot holes across the leaf surface. This type of damage is typically not economically important, but however, when the larvae reach those greater instars, such as starting at the fourth instar, they're capable of much greater damage, such as this plant here. You can see that this plant has been cut off almost at the ground level, and this type of damage was done by a fourth or greater larval instar. This is when the damage starts to become economically important, because this leads to stand loss, which leads to yield loss.